Okay, so for the COBOL lesson today, let me explain how the procedure division of a COBOL program under structured programming was usually set up. I'm using Excel here to draw the diagram. Okay, so you would normally start off, you have your procedure division, right? And then your first paragraph number would be something like 00000 begin, right? And then you would have three areas starting from that. And different people had different styles of how they did the numbering, right? But you could have a area called initialization, and you could have a area called 200 mainline, right? And you could have an area called 900 EOJ, meaning end of job or end, right? So in here, the initialization, you would normally open your files, input and output, and do anything else that you have to do at the beginning of the program, right? In 900, you would close your files and stop run, right? And in here, the mainline, you would do whatever is the normal processing, which was usually you would do a loop. You would read a record from the input file, and then you would do your processing, right? And your processing would probably involve other paragraphs, like in the example I did yesterday, right? So for example, you could have a paragraph 210 for low income. Suppose you're writing a program to calculate tax. You would have a paragraph for a low income. If it's a low income, you would have a paragraph for a medium income. And you would have a paragraph for high income, right? And then within that, you could have other paragraphs underneath that, and it could go on for many levels, right? Like for example, if it's high income, suppose there's a surtax, right? So you could have another paragraph underneath that that's being called by perform to do a surtax, right? And then there could be some other thing for, I don't know, political contributions, right? Right, so the idea was that if you have a paragraph 231, then you know it's being called by 230. And if you have a paragraph 230, you know it's being called by 200, right? Because you can see the numbering scheme that's being used. And some people used a different numbering scheme, right? Like some people used six-digit numbers, some people used three-digit numbers. It depends on what the style is in the particular company that you were working for. But most people would use like a style like that. And then there could also be paragraphs that are called from more than one place. Like for example, suppose low income, medium income, and high income, just for an example. Let's take that. You can have a political contribution no matter how high your income is, right? So that is something that doesn't depend on your income, right? So there could be something out in another area, say like a paragraph 800 political, and that could be called from three different places, right? So therefore, it wouldn't be called 211, it wouldn't be called 221, it wouldn't be called 232, right? And if you were good, you would put a comment in here saying, this paragraph is being called from three different places. It'd be called here, here, and here. Unfortunately, with the old programs, in most cases, people had either no comments or very few comments. So it was just a matter of you having to sit down for a long time and figure out what was going where by normally printing out the program on paper and then going through the whole program with a bunch of colored pencils and rulers and drawing lines to see where the flow went from one place to another until you finally figured out what it was doing. And of course also running the program and testing it to see what it actually did. So that's a COBOL lesson for today, and thanks for watching.